Up, Wes Cow.
Before Idol, I was playing in a bar every night of the week. I had a big, hard look at myself and I just felt like I wasn't really being everything I could be. I've kind of struggled with the fear of failure. It was a massive decision to walk in that audition room. To be in front of the judges is probably the biggest risk I've taken. And when Dicko sort of gave me a hug, that was a special moment for me. And I thought, oh, wow. Somebody's actually validating that I can actually might be able to do this for a living. Top 100, I love playing the Sydney Theatre. That was great. That was the first sort of taster of the Idol audience. Once it got to the 12, you could just feel the intensity rising. It is like a big roller coaster ride, especially with all the interviews and all the press and all the TV. I feel like I've grown as a man more so than as an artist. A bit more comfortable in my own skin. Ever since I was five, all I've really wanted to do is music, and I've never really kind of had any interest in anything else. And to be here now and to be doing what I love the most, I'm just, the first time in my life I'm actually proud of myself. Give me your
tomorrow. They topped the charts for the Rolling Stones in 1968. Kicking us off, Wes Carr, Jumpin' Jack Flash.
I was born in a crossfire hurricane.
Wes, the Rolling Stones is a byword for noisy, dirty rock and roll, and that's what you gave us. An immense start to the show, truly great. The interesting thing about you is it appears the more iconic the band or the song you're doing, the bigger you become. You inhabit these songs really, really well. The other thing about that, it's the first time we've seen that dirty, raw texture in your voice, and it's great. It's going to give you more options. Epic, mate, epic.
Thank you, man. Cheers.
You know, you said in the piece before you started this thing that you're incredibly proud of yourself and you really feel like you have grown. I have to say, ditto, I think I have to congratulate you. You're one of the most consistent performers I know of. And you're not scared. You know what I mean? You get on stage, you take over. Well done, Wes.
Thanks. Thanks, Martha. Thank you.
Now, I can't just lick you like a mother cat every week here because you're pretty good, right? But I just groom you. The thing, I totally understand what Dicko's saying. You get the song and you make it your own. That's one thing that everyone loves about you, but you also give the song the performance level that it's required. I love the dancing around. I love the little Rolling Stones, the weirdo dance thing that you did. You had to do it. You had to do it, but mate, the whole place erupted on song one, and that's all it takes, man. Good work.
Thanks, mate. Thank you. Cheers.
Go to Rio. You don't make friends with salad. You don't make friends with salad. Sorry. Bit of maraca work, mate. We've seen maracas. We've seen you on the piano. We've seen you on the mouth harp. What's next? What is in store?
I've run out. That's
no.
It. There you go.
Bit of tambo?
It was either that or maracas, and I thought they were more interesting. They look better.
You know what?
Tambourine.
What? Good choice.
Thanks.
If you want to keep Wes around, then you have to vote for him. 1902-555-561. Or make sure you vote for him just by SMSing Wes to 191010.